Steve Harvey. I'm excited to be here, so let's get it on. Etisan, Ghana. Everybody in a good mood today?
Yes.
All right, let me explain to you how the game works. Our researchers have been all over the streets of Ghana asking you some answers to some literally just simple questions. All our families got to do is match those answers up to those questions that's locked in on this game board behind me. The team that answers the most questions, get the most points, will walk away with a chance at the jackpot $5,000. Well, if you want to meet the families, everybody say yeah.
Yeah!
From Acura, it's the Jubilee Boys. From Greater Acura, it's the Camel family. Yeah, this ought to be interesting today.
Yeah.
Welcome to the show. Surveyed 100 people. Top 7 answers on the board. Name something you wouldn't wear to an interview.
Bikini, underwear.
Bikini.
Tattered clothes.
Oh, tartan.
Exactly.
I wouldn't wear tartan. I wouldn't wear tartan clothes to an interview. Tartan.
You can wear.
Well, I'm just saying. See, you can wear bikini drawers to an interview because they ain't gonna know. See, you could have on bikini drawers right now. No one knows.
But I'm not.
Well, you don't mean you say you don't.
I'm just saying I'm not.
We don't know that. I might have on bikini drawers right now. No one would know.
That's true.
Okay.
Gotcha.
Pass or play?
We're playing,
Steve. Let's go. Irene, how are you, darling?
I'm doing perfect, Steve.
Good, good. What do you do?
I'm an administrative consultant for a public figure.
A creative consultant?
Administrative consultant.
Oh, administrative consultant.
Exactly.
For a public figure.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, well, this is going to be quite interesting.
It's
going to
be great.
So do they know that you are here today?
Yes, they do.
You had permission to come and play a game while they're somewhere needing desperately administrative consultant.
We all need money, Steve.
This public figure should be paying you rather handsomely. But obviously not enough. So she's here to win 5,000 more.
Oh, yeah.
All right, introduce everybody, Irene.
Okay, Steve. So this is Afua.
Hi.
Afua. Okay.
Yes. That's Rita.
Rita.
Yes.
Rita?
Rita?
Rita, yes.
And that's Samira.
Hi.
Okay, good.
So we are all sisters from different mothers, and we've known each other for 15 years.
15?
Yeah. 15 years, Steve.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
15. That's good to have friends that long. Efa?
Yes, please.
What do you do?
So I'm a pharmacist in a government institution.
Oh, drugs.
Yeah, medication, drugs. Not drugs.
No, no, drugs.
No, when you say drugs or something.
No, they're drugs. Well, you call it medication if you want to. But if you take enough of it, then it's drugs. Yes.
Exactly.
All right, name something you wouldn't wear to an interview.
Well, Steve, I wouldn't wear a pair of jeans trousers to an interview.
Good
a pair
answer.
Of jeans trousers. Rita, better known as Rita. Rita, what do you do for a living?
I'm a secretary for a public figure.
Oh. this public figure, would it happen to be the same public figure as her?
Yes, yes. Please.
The whole office is off today. Ain't nobody at work today. This public figure is sitting somewhere in trouble. The secretary, the administrative coordinator, just, ugh. All right, name something you wouldn't wear to an interview.
Steve, I'm gonna go with short or exposing dresses.
Good.
Short or exposing dresses. Get a job, though. Short or exposing dresses?
Yeah.
Samira?
Yes.
What do you do?
I'm an anesthetist in a private hospital.
So you build bird nests for somebody?
No. I give anesthesia for a living.
You give anesthesia for a living?
Yeah. To those coming for surgery.
I've had surgery before. And you give me anesthesia. Mm-hmm. So in the States, that's called an anesthesiologist.
Yeah.
In the States. What is it called here?
With that, with what you're saying, anesthesiologist is a doctor anesthetist, and I am a nurse anesthetist. So I still give anesthesia here, but I'm not a doctor.
Yeah. In other words, if you come to her hospital, you could die. I'm gonna need some anesthesiology. If you give me anesthesis for anesthetizing the system, and I am allergic to the anesthetist of anesthetizing, I am going to die. All right, let's play. Name something you wouldn't wear to an interview.
Very transparent clothes.
Good answer.
Transparent clothes.
Good answer.
All right, only one strike. Irene, name something you wouldn't wear to an interview.
Steve, I'm not gonna wear slippers to an interview.
Slipper.
Good answer.
Efa?
Yes.
Efa. Name something you wouldn't wear to an interview.
Steve, I'm not going to wear a crazy hairstyle to an interview.
Not going to wear the crazy hairstyle. Oh. It's all good, yeah? Rita, we have two strikes. We have to be careful. Jubilee boys can steal. Name something you wouldn't wear to an interview.
Steve, I wouldn't wear too much makeup.
Good! Good! Yeah! Good answer.
I wouldn't wear too much.
That depends on how you look without it. Don't worry. You need to wait and hear these answers, ladies. Could be clapping for nothing. Name something you wouldn't wear to an interview.
Steve, we're gonna go with a t-shirt.
A t-shirt! Seven.
Five.
Three.
Source.
Well, let's go. Jubilee Boys, 56. Caramel, not on the board yet. Don't go away. We'll be right back. We're playing Feud. Got a long way to go. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. In the battle of the sexes, the Jubilee Boys got 56. Caramel not on the board. Give me Barack. Give me Efua. Is that Barack like in Barack Obama?
Barack Ghana.
It's a good name. We happen to love Barack Obama.
Thank you.
That's right.
All right, let's just play the game. Surveyed 100 people, top 7 answers on the board. Here we go. Name an important place where your phone should not ring.
Meeting.
At a meeting.
Church.
Church.
Good answer.
They don't play. Rita, name an important place where your phone should not ring.
Steve.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna go with... Steve.
Yes, me. Samira.
Yes, Steve.
How are you today?
I'm good.
Wonderful, wonderful, darling. Absolutely wonderful. Name an important place where your phone should not ring.
Your phone should not ring in a lecture hall.
Good answer.
Your phone should not ring in the lecture hall. Irene, name an important place where your phone should not ring.
At a family gathering.
Good answer.
I always want my phone to ring at a family gathering so I can stop talking to my family. At a family gathering. All right, now, listen to me. Come on. We got 2 strikes. We need this one. Jubilee Boys can steal. Name an important place where your phone should not ring.
Steve, I'm going to go with Bank and Hall.
Great answer.
Now, let the Bank and Hall.
That's so good. It's good.
I don't even know what that is. Name an important place where your phone should not ring.
Steve, we're gonna go with at a funeral.
At a funeral. Number 6.
Conference.
4.
Job interview.
3. For double the points. We're playing Family Feud, man. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a good one now. Jubilee Boys got 56. Caramel Girls got 63. Give me Nat. Give me Rita. Very good. Welcome, guys. In this round, we've doubled the points. Surveyed 100 people. Top 6 answers are on the board. Name something that cannot work without a battery.
Phone.
Touchlights.
Flashlight. Touchlight.
Guys, you gonna play? Yeah, you're playing.
Play.
That's right.
All right, man. Let's meet everybody, man. How you doing?
I'm good, Steve. How are you?
Good. What do you do?
So I am a medical laboratory scientist.
Medical laboratory scientist. You had to go to school for that.
Yeah, a lot of school.
A lot of school, yeah. I wouldn't have made it. Yeah, I flunked out of school.
Yeah, I heard.
Introduce everybody, man.
All right, Steve, so this is Barack. He's a personal trainer.
Yeah.
As you can see.
Oh, man. So you make that jump, I make this jump.
Yeah. That's some Michael Jackson move then.
Yeah, that's Michael Jackson. Yeah, I taught that to him. Taught Michael how to dance.
Really?
Go ahead.
Okay, so next up is Nat. He is a former footballer and now he's a businessman.
Uh-huh.
And we have Prince, who's a data analyst as well, yeah.
All right, welcome to the show, fellas.
Thanks, Steve.
Prince?
Yes, sir.
Name something that cannot work without a battery.
You can't start a car without a battery.
Can't start a car without a battery, baby. Whoa. Cannot. Car!
Whoa!
Shmani.
Hi, Steve.
Name something, brother, that cannot work without a battery.
Well, Steve, I'll settle for a portable radio.
Radio!
Good answer, good answer, good answer!
We see you.
Yeah, a lot of hate over there. I mean, they doing it all. You see them too, don't
I
you?
See them.
Okay, all right. It's a battle of the sexes. It's tight. It's 56 to 63. Let's make it happen. Name something that cannot work without a battery, Barack.
Yeah, Steve, I will go for a microphone.
A microphone.
No problems.
Nat, we got to be careful, man. We got two strikes. The girls is throwing shade, man. They giving you the everything. The battle of the sexes. This is the men, the boys against the girls, the men against the women.
They ain't taking this. They can't.
They ain't.
They are not taking this.
They are not taking it.
Oh.
You're not.
Okay. They look pretty confident over there. They are kind of cute, though. I'm going to have to tell you that right there. If they don't take it, they looking pretty good over there. Name something that cannot work without a battery.
Steve, you cannot use a wristwatch without a battery.
Whoa!
You cannot use a wristwatch without a battery.
It's out there, it's out there.
Watch.
Whoa! My man.
Prince.
Yes, Steve.
Two strikes. Caramel Sisters can steal. Name something that cannot work without a battery.
TV remote.
What?
TV remote.
TV remote. The remote.
Oh! Good.
That's right.
Ladies, they are fighting hard. The boys don't want to go down. Two strikes. Caramel Sisters can steal. One answer on the board, you can clear it. Name something that cannot work without a battery.
Steve, I think we all have this in our homes. I will go with a wall clock.
Yes, Steve, good answer.
A wall clock,
sir.
Ladies, here's a chance to separate yourselves a little bit. Name something that cannot work without a battery.
Steve?
Huh?
I'm gonna go with a toy car.
Good answer.
A toy car. Well, let me have both of your attention because now this involves all of you. Everybody on this stage has something to play for because this is the last round. Whoever wins this round right here will have enough points to go on for play for the jackpot, $5,000. JUBILEE BOYS are leading with 216 and the Caramel Sisters got 63. This game belongs to any one of you. Let's get it on. Give me Prince, give me Samira. Did you look in her eyes?
Yes, Steve.
Yeah, you did?
Yes.
Oh, that's trouble, partner. That's trouble. Never look in their eyes when the game is on the line.
Yes, Steve.
Never look in a woman's eyes.
It's time for money.
Yes, it's money time. This money time, yeah. Man. We ain't got time for this here.
No,
but it's too late. You looked. In this round, points are triple. Surveyed 100 people, top 5 answers on the board. Name something people do to prepare for a date.
They buy a flower.
They buy a flower.
They get all dressed up.
They get all dressed up.
Great answer.
Good answer. Pass or play?
We're gonna play.
We play.
We're gonna play. Yeah. Ladies, if I were you, I would try to keep it over here. I gotta give them brothers over there some credit. They play pretty good. All right, so here we go. Name something people do to prepare for a date.
Steve, I'm gonna say they floss their teeth.
That's a really weird answer. They floss. They don't brush them, they just floss them. One strike, ladies. Let's go. Name something people do to prepare for a date.
Steve, I'll get my hair done to prepare for a date.
A new hairstyle!
Good answer, good answer. Yeah. Yeah.
All right, we're holding on, lady. Rita! Only one strike, darling. Name something. Skip this. Name something you do to prepare for a date. Forget people.
Steve, I'll buy a new dress or shoe.
You buy a new dress or shoe. You buy a new dress or shoe.
Good answer.
The ladies are fighting hard. They are trying to maintain pressure. Only one strike, Samira. Name something people do to prepare for a date.
Steve, I'll go with they buy condoms.
Say this about that answer. That is a very, very smart answer. Please protect yourselves out here. Please. Please. Two strikes. Let me tell you how important this is. You have two strikes. If it's there, you're still alive. If it's not there, the JUBILEE BOYS can steal and win the game. Name something people do to prepare for a date.
Steve, I'm gonna say they put on a cologne.
they put on cologne. JUBILEE BOYS, let me tell you what's happening here, fellas. It's real simple. This is it. There are two answers left on the board. If you give me either one of those answers, number two or number three, your team will win the game. Your team will be playing for $5,000. If you miss it, those points go to the Caramel Girls, and they will win the game. This is it. This is for the game. One answer does it. Here we go. Name something people do to prepare for a date.
Well, Steve, after getting dressed and all that, you have to get to the venue, the location of the date.
Oh, okay. You have to book. You have to book the location.
Where you're going, yeah.
Okay, you have to book where you're going. This is going to the location. Get it booked.
Steve, you pray for a date? You pray?
No, because I don't want to drag the Lord into it. Hey! Yeah. I need two of you! Back to the Feud, everybody. The Caramel family won the game. And now it's time to play
Fast Money.
All righty, fool. Here's how Fast Money works. Irene is off stage. She can't see or hear any of your answers. I'm going to ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. You can't think of something, you just say pass. I'll get back to it if we have enough time left. Then if you and Irene together come up with 200 points, tell everybody how much you're going to win.
$5,000.
$5,000. Very proper there. You want to say dollars. You don't want to say dollars. You want to say dollars. Are you ready?
I'm ready, Steve.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name something you do before breakfast.
Brush my teeth.
Name something you would find in a barbershop.
The zippers.
A place where you would find a book.
Library.
Something you turn on in the morning.
Lights.
A place where you are asked to stand up.
Church.
Come on, let's go. Come on, fool. Let's go. Come on now. I want to give away some money. Let's see. Name something you do before breakfast. You said, you brush your teeth. Survey said, boom. Name something you would find in a barber shop. You said, zippers. Survey said, a place where you would find a book. You said, the library. Survey said, something you turn on in the morning. You said, lights. Survey said.
Oh, that's
pretty good. That's normally where we stop. We usually get about that. Let's see how much more we can add. A place where you are asked to stand up. You said church. Survey said, boom. Boom. Irene?
Yeah?
I have some good news for you.
Okay.
And I have some bad news. Which one would you like first?
Bad news first.
The bad news.
Yeah.
If you don't get this, you won't be riding home with them.
That was the good news.
She got 160 points. I gotta tell you now, In spite of that, I do want you to know that getting 40 points in the second position is still difficult.
But it's doable.
Yeah, it's very doable.
Yeah.
Girl, we gonna win this money.
We taking it home.
Okay. Sure hope so, because I think we can do it, though.
Yeah.
I'm going to ask you the same 5 questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you'll hear this sound. I'll say, try again, you give me another answer. Now, it's gonna be tougher this time, so we're gonna give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Yes, I'm ready, Steve.
All right, let's remind everyone of Efua's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Focus for me, okay? Okay. Name something you do before breakfast.
Brush my teeth.
Try again.
Take my bath.
Name something you would find in a barbershop.
Scissors.
A place where you would find a book.
In a church.
Something you turn on in the morning.
The lights.
Try again.
The TV.
A place where you are asked to stand up.
In church.
Try again.
At school.
All right, let's go. We need 40 points for $5,000. Name something you do before breakfast. You said you bathe. Survey said? Number one answer was brush your teeth. 30 points from $5,000. Name something you would find in a barber shop. You said scissors. Survey said? Number one answer was razor blade. Razor blade. We are 20 points away. A place where you would find a book. You said church. Survey said? Number one answer was library. 11 points from $5,000. Something you turn on in the morning, you said? The TV. Survey said? Church was the number one answer. Boy, they scared me right there. All right, ladies, so here's the deal. You won the $5,000 for the jackpot, but you walk out with a grand total of $6,140. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time. Yeah. Yeah. good time. I hope you had a good time.